Sports are emotional. They touch your very soul. Wins are great, but pain lasts forever. Happiness is fleeting. Pain lasts forever.
You're a husband and a father and a writer and a filmmaker, but a good third or quarter is a basketball player.
That's what I said. We got the white guy so we can make it even.
I swear to God, he scored 12 straight points without missing.
The biggest game I ever played in high school was my senior year Central Jersey Finals, which doesn't sound so big, but when you're from Highland Park, a little town in New Jersey, it was a big deal because we were playing New Brunswick, a big city across the river. And for years, New Brunswick had just kicked our ass. Clock's ticking down. They kicked it to this kid named Cassius Hargrove, who I only know because he cold-bloodedly stuck this like 20-foot jumper right in my face.
So I haven't been here in 27 years. I can still feel the ball passing by my fingers. Right on its way to the basket towards breaking my heart.
Like, let's put it this way. I've never cried like I did in that game.
Not over the death of your father?
No.
Just a small little borough against a big bad city, and you're so close geographically. You almost had all the elements there for a stinking riot.
Clearly, it was an anti-Jewish act. And these folks saw Highland Park as a Jewish town.
Don't go across that bridge. Even your parents tell you, don't go across the bridge.
Why was that?
Because of the racial profile.
The police.
When I first started this, you know, all I really cared about was the game itself. But then I started flipping over rocks, and I realized there was so much more here going on.
There was something mysterious about Joel that I never really understood.
Did you know that he'd been stabbed in the leg before the game?
Absolutely not. No idea. But I am noticing that he's wearing a wrap.
He said he'd be here all night.
I know. Well, he maybe just ran out to get some beer or something.
I call Joel Houdini because one minute he's here, next minute he's gone.
And what about Cassius Hargrove? Did you even
know? I have
know
no who? Idea who he was. I heard about him after the game was over.
He's like the basketball boogeyman. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I got to find out whatever happened to him, and I got to find out how he holds this moment differently than I did.
That's almost like blood, sweat, and tears, man. And if you look at what's going on now, it's like it never even happened.
I think everybody has something painful in their past that they wish they could go back and change. We can't rewind the tape, go back in time, but maybe this is your way of doing that.